I don't know their names, they just go by the initials A and B, so I don't know who they are. So can you put your hands together for A and B?
Change me from my worst behavior. Wanna get regenerated from my human nature. Not sure you can relate from another same cause. Put your up and trust in this world is falling away. Pick up the call, Christ calling today. Hey,
he's taking for you, man. He made a decision.
Tell him
there's a great commission, Christian.
Hey,
Jesus is the focus.
Yes, he is.
Jesus is the motive.
Okay.
No lies, no compromise. I'ma keep my eyes on the prize. I'ma keep on running, I'ma keep my eyes on the prize. Hey, I'ma keep on running, I'ma keep my eyes on the prize.
That's right, that's right.
I'ma keep on running, I'ma keep my eyes on the prize. Hey,
yeah. I'ma keep my eyes on the prize. Television. With me, it's got to still a hand in collision. With Jesus Christ in the day, I'm making decisions, I'm a servant. Like I'm a slave, but now I'm forgiven. No, everything is sin. Sin is my only thing, saved by his name. I'm black Christian, the love of men is by the good and good human being. All I've been for since prison, I remember it quite vivid. I'm doing but quite sinning. Stuck in my sin, my mindset was quite rigid.
Hey.
This came from Jesus Christ, came when delivered.
Hey.
Me and my whole family for the world's wicked. Ways, it's the ancient of days. I get praise, waiting to see. You believe you bring change.
That's right.
You return the road, ending is real. Come out the blue like a boy, agenda revealed.
Woo!
You see, they're forgiven.
That's right.
Clap your hands to them.
There's a great commission.
Let me see you clap your hands.
Jesus is the focus.
Yes, the focus.
Jesus is the motive.
Only way.
No lies. Sing it back.
I'ma keep on running. I'ma keep my eyes on the prize. Sing it out. Sing it out.
I'ma keep on running. I'ma keep my eyes on the prize. Yeah. I'ma keep on running. I'ma keep my eyes on the prize. Keep on running, I'ma keep my eyes on the prize.
Hey,
thankful I'm saved, you know that the garbage is paid. My parents are paid,
won't go
back. The devil trying to knock me out,
flat out my face.
Bothering and weaving like Cassius Clay. It's a miracle I'm standing today, I've been delivered. Listen, I'd rather be taken out than given. Even in the, I won't fit in, I'm made different. I have to be made redundant because I ain't quitting.
Rep the Lord, and there's nobody greater than.
Should have been dead or gone, but he just changed the plan. Of this Guyanese and Jamaican man. It's the bread of life, so I go hard though.
Planting.
Anyways, back to the topic, big up my African brothers.
Cause we love flows.
I ain't talking action up, but I say he saved his refugees from my past.
Hey. You saved them, forgiven.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
You made your decision.
Woo!
Christian,
what a remains on a vision.
Hey, Jesus is the focus.
That's right.
Jesus is the.
Hey,
no lies, no compromise. I'ma keep on running, I'ma keep my eyes on the prize. I'ma keep on running, I'ma keep my eyes on the prize. I'ma keep on running, I'ma keep my eyes on the prize. I'ma keep on running, I'ma keep my eyes on the prize. I'ma keep on running, I'ma keep my eyes on the prize. I'ma keep on running, I'ma keep my eyes on the prize. I'ma keep on running, I'ma keep my eyes on the prize. No lies, no compromise.
Let's make some noise for Jesus Christ in this place tonight.
Yeah, my name's Anne, and I just want to tell you a little bit about my life before I met Christ and my life since. So I came from a very dysfunctional family. My parents weren't married, and they split up when I was a baby. We went into children's home, and so I never really had a conventional family life. And then when I was about 15, my brother had a psychotic breakdown, and we all left the home because we'd all been beaten up by him. And so I went into a hostel when I was about 15, and then I ended up having a flat. And I think from there, even though I started playing up at school when things were bad at home, and I stopped studying, stopped caring about school. But yeah, from when I was about 15, I was on my own, and I ended up in a hostel in a flat. And I got into trouble with the police. I started taking drugs. I first started smoking weed when I was probably about 13, 14. And then it just grew into other drugs. And I became addicted to heroin and crack cocaine. And you can imagine the lifestyle that goes with that. I was just doing a lot of immoral things. And I went to prison three times, and every time I went, I said, this is it. And I'd always believed in God, but I was brought up a Catholic, so I never knew about the relationship we could have with Jesus. And so, I would pray when I was in trouble and say, God, just get me out of this, and I promise I won't do it again. And of course I would. And that was my life for many years. I ended up having two children to a drug dealer, and we had a very dysfunctional relationship, a lot of violence. And I would leave him and come back and leave him and come back. And then finally I left and I came to London. I'm from Manchester originally. And stupidly I thought I would go to London where I didn't know anyone and then I'd stay off the drugs. And of course, you can't move away from your problems. Your problems will always come with you, as they did. And very soon, within weeks, I found another drug dealer and off I was again. And that was my life for many years, until at the age of 34, I came to this church and I heard a sermon that I'd never heard anyone preaching like that before. And it really spoke to me. And for the first time, I felt God's spirit talking to me. And I put up my hand at the end when I was asked to come forward. Anyone who wanted to give their life to Jesus to come forward, which I now know is the altar call. And yeah, I said a sinner's prayer. I said that I believed in Jesus. I believed that he died on the cross and that he, you know, had come to save me. And I asked for forgiveness. And straight away, I felt the forgiveness. I felt all the heaviness lift from me. And I was a changed person from that day. I remember I left church that night and I tried to light up a cigarette and it just tasted disgusting. And I tried again the next day and the same thing. So yeah, that was the end of that. I was also addicted to methadone at the time as well. And some ladies in church prayed with me and I was able to get off all addictions. And yeah, my life did change. I still had problems, I still had issues, but I now knew that there was a hope, that there was a hope in Christ, that I didn't have to live that way. And yeah, some years later, so I came to church a single mom, and about 4 years later, I met someone in church, and we got married, and we had a son. Woo, woo, woo. But I just knew, like, the difference of being married and, you know, and having a child and not being married and having children out of wedlock was just night and day. Like, it was just so, so different. Just a marriage that has been blessed, a union that has been blessed by God is just so different. And we've had our struggles, believe me. As Pastor would say, it's been an adventure. But, you know, I wouldn't change it for the world. I wouldn't change my life now for the world. And the one thing I just want to add before I get dragged off, because I know it's 3 minutes and under, and that's difficult for me, is that no matter what I go through, no matter what life throws at me, and how many times I may fall, I just thank God for Jesus, because I have his grace, and he's just been so graceful and so merciful for me, and I'll be forever grateful. That's my testimony. Thank you.
Hello everyone, my name's Chantel and I've been saved for, oh my goodness, I got saved when I was 17 and I'm 32 now. and this song I'm about to minister, I pray that you are encouraged by it to not want to be in hell. Yeah, when you're ready, bear with me as well, my throat is suspect, but in Jesus' name.
Judgment.
The next song I'm about to minister as well is the flip side to that. So the way you can make heaven your home is through accepting Christ as your Lord and Savior. We believe that it's through a sinner's prayer, confessing of your sins and acknowledging Christ as your Lord and Savior. And we call that being saved, and it's a gift of salvation, and I pray that you're ministered by this as well.
We're going to minister a couple songs. This first one's called Wash Clean. It's a simple song with a simple message, and that's Jesus loves you, and he wants you to accept him to his heart. So listen to the words and be blessed.
There's a God who loves our soul. He wants no man to perish, no. So he sent his son to die, may have eternal life. When Christ died on Calvary's cross, he saved the wicked and the lost. There's a God who loves us so. He wants no man to perish, no. It's finished, cried in anguish and in pain. Him on
next song we're going to sing is called Lifeline. So listen to the lyrics and yeah, let's speak to you.
To the front to give his testimony. Keep clapping as he comes. It's a groundhog moment. Sorry, is Eden there? Eden? Okay, what we're gonna do, we're gonna welcome our brother, Ernie Toppin up. Put your hands together, Ernie.
Just so I can, so there's no gap in testimony, because we want to glorify God. I'll just give a quick testimony as Kavan and Chantel are going to come up. They're going to help me do this song. My testimony, I was born into a very dysfunctional family, and I ended up basically, to cut a long story short, I was part of a street gang. We were kind of, you know, making money and doing wicked things, and my conscience started to get to me. And when I was in this gang, I met this girl called Karen, and I kind of, me and her have kind of locked off and fell in love, and we just got out of the gang. Then I realised, you know what, I need to change my life. So I started to, while I was in the gang, we was in a sound system and I used to sing. And so I started singing and I started to try and get noticed in the West End. I met a guy who knew a guy who knew a guy, and I ended up in a band. We did a gig in the Hippodrome. There was a guy in the audience who said, that guy's brilliant, I want him to sing. And so I got a contract, I started singing, and I started bigger and bigger gigs, more and more exposure. I did a track for A&M Records, that started going viral. And then and someone came up to me in the street. I was 26 years old, 25 years old. And she said to me, where would you go if you die right now? And I kind of said, you know, I'd go to heaven. And then I kind of realized, no, you wouldn't. Because when you was in that gang, you did all kind of street robberies, burglaries, if there's any police, it was a long time ago. And you did all kinds of wicked things, and you're not going to heaven. And I wrestled with that. I was terrified. I started to realize there will be a reckoning for my sins and for your sins. And a lot of these songs are written out of those realizations. And I've tried to bring that same record, you know, that revelation into my songs. Like, we are going to stand before God one day. And so this song's called Have You Ever Wondered? Because everyone's, we've all stared at the same sun and we've all looked at the same moon and we've said, what is life about? And Jesus is the way. Listen to this song. Have you ever wondered, yeah, what this life's all about? As you slowly sink into sleep, yeah, you can't hide, no, you can't hide, you can't hide on that judgment day. It's gonna be you wailing, oh, wailing, and gnashing of teeth, yeah. But Jesus is away. Jesus is away. This is the only way. Salvation has got to be today. Yeah. And how many times you're going to hear this gospel and then just rub it off. One fine day is gonna be too late, and you'll be on the other side. What you gonna say to God? Hey, I was going to, Lord, please, please, please. It's gotta be today. Oh yeah. One day you're gonna see it. 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 What you gonna say to God? I was really going to, Lord. Is a way, oh yeah.
Jesus is the only, only way to salvation. It's gotta be, really gotta be today. Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Round of applause for Kavan and Chantel. Yeah. As always, they nailed it.
One fine day,
there it is.
You slip away from this mortal life, and you cross over, and at your shoulder there'll be a voice saying, child, this is your time. And on that day, you will receive a chance to be born again. But will you take it? Are you gonna make it to the other side? Can decide. See, you gotta choose it. Yeah, yeah, yeah. You gotta choose it. Yeah. You better choose Jesus here today, because it's just too late on the other side. And one fine day, you'll slip away from this mortal life, and you cross over, and at your shoulder there'll be a voice saying, child, this is your time. And on that day, everything we have and everything we see will disappear in a moment. And everybody's gonna know that Christ was King, and what the Bible says, it was right. Oh, you better choose. You better choose it. Oh, yeah, yeah. You better choose Jesus here today, because it's just too late on the other side. One fine day, I sincerely pray, from this mortal life, as I cross over, that at my shoulder there'll be a voice saying, son, what you did was right. And on that day, my eyes will see the to be born again. It surely was the best way. It's gonna be the best day, yeah, of my life. The day I meet the risen Christ. Oh, oh, cause I choose him. Yeah. I said I choose. I choose Jesus here and now today. Yes, I choose Jesus in my life.
Oh man, that was nice. Music, man, music's beautiful. Music cuts through. Music gets into people's hearts. I pray this song gets in your heart. This song was written after I had a revelation of where a lot of my dead friends who was in gangs, you know, where they're gonna end up. And you know, some of them who, you know, there's no other destiny for them than this, because they live their lives a certain way, and you can't live in a certain way and then die and go to heaven. So this song's a warning.
Is all your fault, cause you pushed away Jesus every time you heard him call. Now you must pay for your soul. Jesus tried to pay, but you told him no. No, I need just 5 more minutes, just 5 more minutes of life, sweet life, and I will pray. I need 5 more minutes, just 5 more minutes of life.